Welcome back to the Blazer Puzzle. It's episode 72. I'm Carl Franklin from AppVnex, and that's my friend Jeff Fritz from Microsoft. Hey, Jeff, what's new?
Hey, great to see you. You know, I can't say too much because I'm under NDA, and I was at MVP Summit last week. So,
oh man, I really want to know what's new.
Well,
going to have to wait for Build, aren't I?
Going to have to wait for Build, maybe .NET Conf and the .NET 10 release as well.
All right. Very good. Hey, let's jump right into this week's puzzle. Roll the music. All right. Well, this one is a little complex, only because we have a lot of models. And we have dropdowns to select the models, like color, episode, which is our episodes or some of our episodes, friends, Jeff Fritz, right?
I know that guy.
We have fruits. We have languages. We have, oh, what am I doing? C sharp.
We have. That's right. There you go.
Metals. Pets. Did you know that, well, Fred Flintstone had a dinosaur, so I put it in there.
You're showing our age.
Yeah. So anyway, the idea is that we have, you know, the things that are selected here. But here's what we want. We want to arrange them, no matter how many there are, in a bootstrap grid of three columns per row with no gaps.
Okay.
So we only have eight lists here, but imagine if there are 20 or more possible lists. Each may or may not be shown depending on who the customer is, right? So we have some business logic that says, oh, if Jeff is using that, we don't want him to see fruits. Or we only want him to see languages and episodes.
Okay.
But, you know, if Carl is using it or whatever, he gets to see, you know, certain ones. So to show how this is done, we have basically a dictionary of string Booleans. So, you know, color is true. So if I take that off, color goes away. But instead of just leaving a blank hole here, I want everything else to wrap around.
That responsive bootstrap, flexible grid approach.
Yeah. So let's take a look at the code. First of all, here are my models over here, colors, episodes. And I did these the same way that you did in other Blazer puzzles, where you just have a record and then you have a list of those records. So they're easy to access. So then let's go down here past the markup to the code. So I have selected color, selected this, selected that. I have a dictionary, which is a string. So the string will be, you know, whatever the models are. Mm-hmm. And then whether we want to show them. And then we are using this toggle when you click on the checkbox for that particular key. We have this, you know, show list dictionary, and we just set the key equal to true or false.
That works.
Yeah. So then I have my selected methods for, you know, on change for each one of these things. And, you know, this could be made more efficient. That's not the point. The point is, how do we get those things to wrap around? So this is what I'm doing. So I have a div container. This is all bootstrap classes. Then I have a row. And so for each one of these models, we only express the markup if this value in the dictionary is true.
Okay.
All right. So we do that for color. We do it for episode. We do it for friends. And then we close the row div. And we add a new row, right? Because this is how you do a bootstrap grid.
Right, right.
So the question is, friends, how do we get that to wrap around? And when we enable or disable certain things, we won't know until runtime what to show and what not to show.
This feels like a dashboard that you're building. And you may want to turn on and off various features that you want to show to various folks based
That's
on
right.
what features they're paying for.
Yeah, there's just some logic somewhere in the business logic that says, You know, at this particular time or for this particular customer, we want to show these particular things, but we don't want to leave holes in a grid. We want them all to wrap around.
Yeah.
So that's it. What do you think? What do you think, Jeff?
Oh, this is, we can solve this with a little bit of JavaScript, a little bit of CSS animation, going to rub a little Vue on it, and it's going to be fantastic.
Yeah. Okay. So this is the point in the show where we give you the time to think about it, but we're not really going to give you the time. You got to give yourself the time. So if you want to think about it, just press pause right now. But if you want to know immediately and you can't wait, just stick around because we'll be right back with the answer after this. All right. So the alert amongst you should have figured this out right away because I'm always showing a column, but that column may or may not have a markup in it.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's just going to be a blank column. It's the positioning of these. We should really put this down here in the closing div tag. Right there, and do that for all of them. Now, the only problem we have is after the first three columns, we close off the row and we add a new row. So we got to get rid of that too, and the other one.
Yeah.
So here is the complete solution. So you can see I'm only expressing the column if we're going to show that, and we also got rid of all of the close row tags and new row tags. So now let's run it again. All right, let's get rid of episodes. Boom.
Yeah, now it's wrapping.
Let's get rid of languages and pets and vegetables and friend. Right? So it works.
Not bad. Not bad.
And the thing that you will notice is that we didn't have to like change the entire grid layout from to like a flex or something like that, right? We're still using the same row and column in the same container. And that's it. Simple.
Not too bad.
You know what? I think this one was tricky because the answer was so right there obvious. And if you were like me, you go down a rabbit hole where you're using dynamic components and, you know,
oh no,
and creating types and all of that stuff. The answer is right there in front of your face.
I did put into the source code, Carl, I did a little bit of refactoring of some of the code that you wrote, and I took each one of those lists that are being displayed and I put them into a little component there so we can make it a little bit easier to show and display and turn on and off those various parts of the user interface.
All right. So what you've done is you've added this component, my list.
Yeah.
Right. And so you have a Boolean parameter to show or hide, a title, an enumerable of T item because you've added a type param. So it's generic. Yep. And then you have an event callback on selected.
Mm-hmm.
You have your T item, which is the selected item. And then you have item text and item value.
Yeah, just a little funk so that you can provide that accessor that reaches into the appropriate property of the record that you want to show.
Yeah, that's nice. And you do this all without reflection.
Yep.
So let's look at what you've done to update home, which is very nice.
Yeah, I put some carriage returns in there so that it was easier to see on one screen here while we're showing it on video like this. But for folks that are working with this in their code, of course, you could stretch this out to just one or two lines with a little bit of wrapping in Visual Studio for you.
And I like this because it's so much cleaner, right? You basically cleaned up all that stuff.
Yep.
In each component. Yeah, very good. And the rest of this is the same, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Now, I could have skipped doing the funks for the item text and item value, and I could have made those template driven. I felt this was just an easy way to do it.
So much easier. Yep. Yeah. And we want to encourage our viewers to do this. You know, anytime you've got repeatable blocks of code or markup, really, markup with code, you know, consider making a component. And I guess, you know, the key is to try to make them as clean as possible.
Oh, yeah.
If you find yourself having to use reflection to pull property values and that kind of thing, probably doing it wrong.
If you're writing the same block of HTML or of UI markup, you write the same 5-6 lines and you're repeating it more than twice, mm-hmm. turn it into a component.
So here's what we got. We can still take away episodes. We can take away languages. Everything works exactly the same. Mm-hmm. Selected pet is now dog, etc. But now it's so much cleaner.
Yeah. Yeah.
Very good. Good puzzle. Well, all right. If you have a puzzle that you want to share with us and hopefully a solution, please send it to us by email at blazerpuzzle@appvnext.com. And who knows, you might get a nice looking Blazer Puzzle mug and or a Blazer Puzzle t-shirt. So hope to hear from you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
Catch you later, friends.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out blazertrain.com and the .NET Show.com for more great content.